Welcome back to a new video about new operator in LINQ. Today I will introduce you the first projection operator in LINQ. So in LINQ we have two projection operators, select and select many. In this video I will explain select operator. And in the next video I will explain select many. But before start explaining select operator, let's understand what does projection mean? Projection is mapping. It means, you map each element from a sequence to a transformed sequence. In other words, it's the process of transforming the results of a query. It means, you have a query to filter the data of the source. At the end you need only the filtered data. To get the filtered data, you have to use a projection operator. Using projection you convert an object into a new form, which holds only those properties, that will be subsequently used. You can also project the original object without changing it. In summary, projection is to get specific data from the entire data. That's all about projection. Let's now start with the first operator, select. Select operator returns an IEnumerable collection of elements based on the transformation function. Let's see the following query to understand the functionality of this operator. I will explain the query step by step, so that you can understand how it works, and how the select operator also works. We have the following array, which contains 5 numbers. In this line we go through all numbers of this array, using the variable n, which we defined in this line. It's like for each loop in any programming language. So n represents the numbers of the array. In the first loop we get the number 1. In the next line we check this number, if it's smaller than 2 or greater than 4. 1 is smaller than 2, so it's true. In this case we move on to the next line, and we select this number. The number will be stored in IEnumerable collection. Then we go back to the second line. Here we get the number 2. Then we check this number, if it's smaller than 2 or greater than 4. It's false. In this case we don't move to select statement, because the condition is false. So we go back to the second line again and get the next number. Then we check if this number is smaller than 2 or greater than 4. It's also false, therefore we don't select it. We get the next number again, and we check it. Number 4 is also not smaller than 2 or greater than 4, therefore we don't select it. Then we take the last number and check it. 5 is greater than 4, therefore we move on to select operator. So we store this number also in the IEnumerable collection. The loop is done now. The result is this variable, which contains only these two numbers, 1 and 5. After the query I added the function to array, to convert the IEnumerable collection to array variable. It means, I will get the following result at the end. As you see, we projected the data from the data source. It means, we only selected the data from the data source. In this example we selected the data in the same form. We had an array and we also selected an array. Let's see the following query about selecting the data, but in a new form. Now I want to select the numbers from the array, and add them into a data table. I have again the same query, but select operator has now a new calculation. Here after filtering the data I add each number, which meets the condition, into a data table. It means, each number will be stored in as row in a data table. After the query I also have the function copy to data table, to convert the output to data table. The output of this query is the following table. As you see, I have again the same result, but in a new form. It's a data table, and not array anymore. These are the two ways to select data. In summary, projection is to select the data from the data source. Either in the same form, like in the first query. Or in a new form, like this query. This is how select operator works. Let's now switch to UiPath to show you different examples about using select operator. In this example I will show you, how to filter a column in data table, and get the result as data table. I have here build data table activity, where I define a table. This table is stored in this variable. It's of type data table. Let's see the table. It consists of two columns, ID and name. I have here different data. Here is the LINQ query, where I filter the table to get only the rows, where the ID number is greater than 3. The table will be stored in the same data table variable. And here I have for each row activity, to print out the rows of the table after filtering. Let's run the code to check the result. As you see, I got only these two rows, where the ID is greater than 3. Here I got a data table as output. It means, I use select operator to get the result in the same form. Data table as input and data table as output. Let's now see the second example. In this example I want to filter the table also, and get only the rows, where the ID is greater than 3. But now I want to get the result in a new form. I want to get the result as array. Here I have again the same table. Here is the query to do that. As you see, I have again the same condition. Then I have this line, to store the content of both columns in a variable x. After that I select this variable. At the end I convert the output to array. The result is stored in this variable. It's a string array. After the query I have this write line activity, to print out the array in the output console. Let's run the code to check the new result. As you see, I got an array as output, which contains the following data. So I got again the same result, as in the first example, but this time I have the result in a new form. It's an array. This is how to use select operator to get the result in a new form. Let's now move on to another important point. To write a LINQ query there are three different methods. Either we use query syntax. The query looks like this one. It's like SQL query. The second method is using method syntax. Like this query. Here we write the functions directly in the same line as extension method. Or the third method is using both query and method syntax, like this query. The first part here is a query syntax. And here we have a method. So it's a mixed method to write a query. I prefer to use this method to write a LINQ query, but you can use any method you are familiar with. In my videos I always use mixed syntax. So the examples, what I showed you before, are using mixed syntax. Let's now see how to use select operator using method syntax. I have again the same table. And here I have this query. First I have the data table. Then I used where statement to set the condition. Here I filter the rows again, to get only the rows, where the ID is greater than 3. After that I used select function, to select each row which meet the condition. At the end I have again copied a data table, to convert the output to data table. As you see, for where and select operators I used function. This is how to use where and select operators using method syntax. What does it exactly mean and how to use it? I will explain that in another video. I have here for each row activity, to print out the result. Let's run the code to check the result. As you see, I got the same result again. Let's now change the query and delete select operator. What will happen now? Let's run the code again. As you see, I got the same result again. It means, select operator is not mandatory, once we use method syntax. Without using it the query will select the rows automatically. So for this kind of simple queries, we don't really need to use select operator. The same also for query syntax or also mixed syntax. If we only have a query like this, where we only have a condition, we can remove select operator, and the result still the same. That's all about select operator. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to write us back. We are happy to help you. See you in the next video about the second projection operator, select many. Thanks for watching and have a great day.